Greetings, Eric Bakker, the naturopath from New Zealand. I'm talking about Pseudomonas aeruginosa. What's the best treatment? You know, we just talked about foods. You're going to eat a healthy diet, it's going to go in your favor. But what are some of the best treatments to actually counter this thing? We tend to see Pseudomonas in certain types of stool tests with people. I've found it quite commonly in people with autoimmune disease. So if you've got Hashimoto's, thyroiditis, or psoriasis, ankylosing spondylitis, Sjogren syndrome, rheumatoid arthritis, any one of 70 odd autoimmune diseases, there may be a potential for you to have elevated Pseudomonas. I also see Pseudomonas in stool test reports of people who've got bladder problems and lung problems and are sick in general with these particular key areas. Now, many doctors watching this video may burst out laughing at this point, saying this guy's, you know, on some kind of drugs or something. Well, I'm not. In fact, I don't take drugs, but what I can tell you, my personal experience, from looking at about 5,000 stool tests, I see a big correlation with Pseudomonas and autoimmune disease. But I also see it in many people with chronic fatigue syndrome and people who've been unwell for a long, long time who can't get well. So what do I do with those cases? How do I treat those sort of cases? One of my favorite things to use with Pseudomonas is grapefruit seed extract. Now, you can buy that in a liquid form. There are many companies that sell it. You can buy it in a capsule form. But it works best when used in combination with other things like berberine and caprylic acid and clove and, you know, whole range and balance of different things. When you're using these together, in my opinion, you're getting a much better effect on normalizing a lot of these pathogens in the gut. Because when we find Pseudomonas in a stool test, we don't just find that. We also find Citrobacter. We also find Candida. We find other bugs that are also, you know, in imbalanced amounts. So looking at a single kill, looking at, for example, ciprofloxacillin or one of these crazy antibiotics that people still take, if you're going to take those for days on end to kill Pseudomonas, you're going to create a massive problem. In fact, you're going to create two problems. One problem is you're going to probably develop antibiotic resistance towards Pseudomonas, which is a very smart bacteria. It knows how to evade capture from many different drugs. And the second one is you're going to destroy a lot of beneficial bacteria in the gut. So there's too much collateral damage. So taking an antibiotic for Pseudomonas, in my opinion, is just craziness. It doesn't really make sense because you're trying to dig a bigger hole than the one you're trying to fill in the first place. When you use grapefruit seed extract, you'll find you will get rid of the Pseudomonas in a stool test. But as I mentioned, if there are other issues there, you're better off taking a broad spectrum product. This is why I got into product development. Years ago, I started to look at something that was effective that could work on things like Pseudomonas. And that's exactly why I created my Candida Remove product. Now, at this point, you may be thinking, here this guy goes again. He's pushing his own wheelbarrow. He's marketing his own products. I couldn't give two hoots where you get your products from. As long as you're using grapefruit seed extract on Pseudomonas, particularly if you find it in the gut, but I also believe it works well on the urinary system, by taking it orally, so you're going to have a good effect. But remember, if you're taking a broad spectrum antimicrobial, you'll have a more complete effect. Normally, I would recommend treatment for Pseudomonas for about 6 weeks to take the grapefruit seed extract a few times per day. If you're taking the Candida Remove tablet, you would take one twice per day for a week or two, and then three times per day. After 6 to 8 weeks retest, Pseudomonas should be gone. Or it should be have dropped from a 3 or 4 plus count down to a 1 plus count, but you will see a reduction. I've seen this in hundreds of cases. So you can get rid of this using natural means. And of course, medical people are not really that keen on natural things. But if you've got Pseudomonas, give it a try and give me some feedback on it. Thanks for tuning in.